Hi guys, it's Kathy. Welcome to my art channel. Thanks for joining me. Today I'm working on a 16 by 20 inch standard canvas. As you can see, I'm doing a split base. The white is Artist Loft Floetrol and Amsterdam titanium white. This is mostly Pthalo blue by Amsterdam, which is semi-transparent. So I mixed it with some thicker paint, a Liquitex lamp black, and I was inspired by a Dutch pour that Olga Sobey did. Anyway, she had a similar layout with the split base. And her colors are poured not all along here, but just here, maybe. I don't suppose it matters because you're going to blow the whole thing out anyway. So, I am using, I believe this is Amsterdam Light Violet to start. Amsterdam Turquoise Blue. This is Amsterdam Greenish-Blue. Oh, got a little goober in here already. That. And there's Amsterdam Permanent Red Violet. It's a little concoction of magenta and an iridescent fine in it. And let's see. This is, don't remember, this is a concoction of stuff. It's Nickle Azo Gold with probably a Liquitex Orange and some red. And this is Amsterdam Primary Yellow mixed with some white. Bit of white on the dark side, and I'm going to put a little bit of dark on the light side. Sounds like something out of Star Wars, doesn't it? Go to the light side, Luke. Or the dark side. Whatever the case may be. Thank you. but don't have a whole lot of white left, but I am just going to scrape all of this off. Well, I'm basically giving up here. I'm just gonna do something very different. I have run out of the most of the white paint. I liked all that nice negative space I had in here. Planned on it going haywire like it did. Still a little, not enough negative space here, but I think that's pretty, and I'm glad I added more of the turquoise and blue green because I love that bluish green. And I can always, you know, when it dries, paint in more negative space, which I definitely want to do here. In fact, I'm going to blow that out a little bit. So, like I said, not what I started with, but I think that's beautiful. I will add more negative space and paint out certain things that didn't go well here and there once it dries, but I'm loving how that looks. Might have to put a little hibiscus stainum, is it stainum, in the middle, but maybe not. Look at this little fire piece here. All right, let me bring you down for a close-up. Okay, so here this is. Turned out very pretty. Again, kind of, you know, when you get in the middle of something, of a pour, and it's just not going the way you want it to. Look at that little flame down there. You know, you're running out of time before the acrylic paint starts to get sticky or dry. And you want to think fast and think, well, what else can I do to save this canvas? And do something different. So just remember, don't get discouraged. I know it's easy. I get discouraged a lot too. And just keep trying. Just play with it. If it doesn't go right, play with the paint. You might learn something new. And anyway, that's my best advice I can give you for fluid art, I guess, is just keep trying. It's only paint. Thank you guys for joining me. And I'll see you next time. Bye-bye. So here this is dry, not yet varnished. I did a little bit of embellishment here and there, mostly around the bottom part, which was, I wanted a little more negative space on the bottom, so I filled a lot of that in with the dark background color. I'm really happy with the flow of this. How the colors blend, and the petals really look like petals. A little bit of fire here and there, especially right here. Looks like a little flame, doesn't it? Center is pretty. So there you have it. Anyway, I hope to be varnishing this and several others pretty soon. Hope you liked it. Thank you so much for joining me. Everyone take care. Be well. Be happy. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.